Hello and welcome to TomTattle.com, where I teach small business owners and entrepreneurs how to create their very first website and drive traffic to it. So a complete beginner can create this website. There's no coding knowledge required. And this website that we will be creating today is a more leads generating website. So if you're in the service industry, you have a small business, say for example, you have a landscaping company, a painting company, a cleaning service, and you want to capture more leads online, this will be the perfect website for you. So let's have a quick overview and see what the website looks like. Okay, in today's tutorial, we will be building this landscaping business website. It is a fake landscaping business that I simply created for this lesson. So keep in mind, you can simply use your own pictures or stock images to create this website for your own business. For example, you could create a cleaning company, a roofing company, or even a painting company, or whatever type of service business website with this website building tutorial. If you need stock images related to your business, you can simply open a new tab and go to tomtattle.com/resources and simply go to the free image section to see where I get great free images. Okay, like I said, a brief tour. On the homepage, we have a rotating slider. That is simply web developer talk for these two images rotating in and out. You can have up to 5 different images if you want here. Notice the call to action button here in red. Get your free quote. And then just below here, we have a brief write-up describing our business in this section. You have an opportunity to include some keywords that you wish to target here. If we simply click on the Our Services section, we have a page where you can feature the various services you provide with clickable links leading to each service page. So you can include as many services or as few if you only want to have one here. I'll show you how you can do that in the tutorial. So if we simply click on a service here, it will lead right to that specific service page. You can have this page dedicated to a specific service, and this page will give you the opportunity to target keywords related to that exact service and help you rank higher in search and lower your cost per click when doing pay-per-click advertising to gain new leads. The way it does this is you've focused your service, your page, right on that exact service instead of offering many different services all on the same page. The search engines pick that up as a positive sign and see that it's hyper-focused when they're sending searchers to that page. This is considered best practice by Google and will help you rise above your competition. At the bottom of each service page, you will notice that we have a free quote request to help you capture emails and phone numbers of your prospective clients. So it's just helping with your sales funnel. So if we click on this quote request, you can see we have the quote form come up here, and this is what it looks like. I will show you how to build a form suited to your business for capturing free quotes. So if we continue on here, we will click on the contact page. And again, you have a simple contact form here that you can create in a matter of a few minutes, and your customers can quickly get a hold of you. If you're concerned what this website will look like on a mobile device, for example, a phone, here it is. It's got the mobile drop-down menu, and you can see as we scroll up and down, there's no pinching or stretching required on this device. It's a very slick, mobile-friendly device for you to capture leads even on mobile devices. So the best way to follow along in this tutorial is with two tabs open. So you'd simply, with one website, one tab, you would have the website building tutorial open, and then the second website, you would simply be building the tutorial. So just simply play and pause the tutorial as it's going along, and then repeat my actions. So I'm ready. If you're ready, let's get started. Okay, welcome to TomTattle.com here. The first thing that you want to do to create this new more leads or more sales business website is simply in your URL bar up top here, or your address bar, type in tomtattle.com/more-sales. That's tomtattle.com/more-sales. I know that's a lot. I'll have a little link or a link in the description below the video. If you want, you can simply click on that as well to get to this page. And this page will have it's still under construction, but it's almost done here. The video will be at the very top here. If you want to reference the 2.5 hour tutorial, you can always come back and work on that here. And I just have a simple three-step process kind of explaining exactly what goes on. There's some helpful tips also here, including what kind of content you should be including in your business website to help drive more leads, and how you should basically structure your page. So anyways, I will quickly head up to step number one here. First thing you want to do is select a domain name. Now, a domain name basically is your address on the internet. So for example, my domain name is tomtattle.com. So if you have your business, let's say you've got, you know, Murray's Plumbing or Steve's Painting or whatever your business name is, you might want to try and incorporate that into your domain name, preferably. So unfortunately, with business names like that, like Murray's Plumbing or Steve's Painting, chances are they're already taken. The internet's been around for, you know, almost 3 decades now, and a lot of those names have been registered or taken. So a way for you to check that, simply right on this page here, you can enter your domain idea right in this blue box here, and then simply click on the check availability button. Now, the great thing about Bluehost is they offer a free domain for your first year, which is a $15 value. So I do encourage you, if you do not already have hosting or want to research hosting, Bluehost is always comes up at one of the top hosts under reviews, but I highly recommend them. I've been with Bluehost for just over 4 years now. I've had hundreds of websites I've hosted over the years, and Bluehost has, I wouldn't recommend something that I wouldn't personally use myself, and that's where most of my sites reside now. As my other ones come up for expiry, I am transferring them all to Bluehost. So on to the domain. So you enter write down maybe 3-4 ideas of domain ideas that you might have. Now, typically short domains, you know, like 4 or 5 letter domains are all taken up. You need something maybe a little longer. And also your extension, this thing that .com at the end, you can also select, you know, .org, .net. There's a bunch of different ones you can see at the end here. But my advice, try and go with .com. Most people, when they're looking on the internet, in at least in North America here, they are used of .com. And when you throw in a .net or .org, they might be, you know, typing in your domain and then throw the .com on the end of it and end up in somebody else's website. So just my experience, you want to go with the .com. So in this example, I am going to create a new website called Online Store Tutorial. Just simply type in your idea and then check and click on check availability. Now, if you'd already had a domain name, you would just leave that box blank that we just typed in the domain name and click on the check availability. Now, we are taken to this screen here. This will ask for us for all our details. Basically, we will select our hosting package. The cheapest rate is $3.95 a month, which is very cheap. It gives us a total of everything. Some of these things I don't necessarily recommend, but I'll let you go through those and decide. And then finally, we enter our credit card information and confirm the details. So I'll just go ahead and enter in all my personal details and then block those out for the video just for safety purposes for myself, and then we'll continue on. Now, one thing I should point out, I know some people have asked me, they get confused when it asks about an international phone number. Just simply in the blue numbers there, punch in your number and then select that international phone number, and you will select either USA or Canada, depending on what country you're from, or UK, or anyways, you'll know what to do. It's pretty self-explanatory. So under the package information section, we have three options here for, do we want to sign up for 3 years, 2 years, or 1 year? So obviously $5.95, 12 months, a lot more expensive, an extra $2 a month. But let's say you have an online store that you're not too sure if it's going to take off, if it's going to fly, and you just want to invest six times 12 is what, $72. You got a $72 investment for 1 year just to test out something that might take off for you. If you have a solid business that you've had around for a while, or you've got an established bricks and mortar business, like say you're a plumber or a restaurant, this probably be the better option and go with the 36 months. The next option that you want would be the domain privacy protection. That's up to you. That's basically if somebody tries to, you know, let's say I have Tom's plumbingwebsite.com, and somebody were to do some searches, they could find out my personal information, my email address, for example, or my phone number, and possibly spam me or get a hold of me. And this is just simply prevents that and makes it the registration private, so that information is not available to the public. Right now, I'm going to take that off, though. If you feel that somebody might be, you know, trying to get that information from you, that's probably a good option. Just for $1 a month, you can add that on there. Site Backup Pro, $3 per month. So you're looking at roughly $36 per year. With Bluehost, they do, I believe it's weekly backups anyways. And the Backup Pro is, if you're constantly doing things daily in there, that might be a great option for you, or if you have a very large website. But if we're just building a simple, small e-commerce website or a small business website, probably not a big deal. So I'm just going to take that off there. Search Engine Jumpstart, $3 per month, $36 a year. I'm taking it off just because I know what I'm doing. That's an option I will leave up to you. When I say what I know what I'm doing, I know how to notify Google and Bing and the search engines, hey, I've got this new website, I'm out there, please come crawl my website and register it in your search engines. So you could also do a simple Google search, and basically you'd be looking for a thing called Webmaster Tools, and it allows you to do what's called submitting a sitemap, and that will automatically notify the search engines to come crawl your website, and your content will be discovered then. So if that sounds too geeky for you and you don't mind spending the $3 a month, and you're a busy business person, maybe that's the route to go. SiteLock Security Find. I've honestly never found any of these little add-on security things that successful. It'll tell you, oh, we stopped, you know, 10 intrusions today, and I just simply will take that off. So right now what we have, total price for 36 months. So for 3 years, you can have a website. It's going to cost you $142.20. Being as I'm just doing a little demo one here, I'm just going to go for the 1 year, and it's an investment of $71.40 that I have a online business here for 1 year. So a pretty cheap investment, I feel. I'm just going to quickly enter in my credit card details, block those out, and I'll click on confirm here and submit. Okay, after clicking on the green submit button with all our details, we're taken to this page. It asks us if we want to have a few other, interested in a couple other offers here from Bluehost. I'm just simply going to click on no thanks. Welcome to Bluehost. Congratulations. Your purchase was successful, and they will send you a confirmation to your email. Now, the next thing is you need to choose a password for your account. Now, this is your Bluehost account. Now, it's important to note when you create a password, there's four conditions that have to be met. You must have at least a lowercase letter, at least one, number one. Number two, you must have at least one uppercase letter. Number three, you need a number. And number four, you need a symbol. So make sure you meet all four of those conditions when you create your password. So once we land into this page, you need to obviously enter in your password. And click on the submit button. Once you do that, you'll be taken to the what we call the control panel, or also commonly known as the C panel. Now, don't get alarmed. Lots of stuff going on here on this page. Very confusing, I'm sure, for the first-time user. The main thing that we will be looking for is if you go down to what website here, and we'll click on Install WordPress. Now, WordPress is just a what they call a content management system. It's just a free open source system that allows you to easily build a website. And over 30% of websites on the internet right now are built with WordPress, as the last stats that I heard. So you'll come to this page and we will click on Install. Notice down here, let us do it for you. Recommended, they say. If you're not into doing this, they will install WordPress for you. $399. The $249 option, $99 option. We are going to do it for free. So we'll simply click on Install. And it asks you select which domain you would like to install to. And it's already, if you're just creating this, you'll only have one domain in there. Just click on Check Domain, the green box here. It says it could take a couple minutes depending on your server, but it never does. Okay, we're almost there. Show Advanced Options, we'll click on that. So site name or title you can put in. You can leave that blank as it is right now, actually. There's admin username, and then it automatically assigns us a password, and it will email that to us. I'm just going to put in something different right now, which I will change later, obviously. I'll put in one of the easiest passwords to crack right here, password 123. Obviously, I'm going to change that. Click on, yes, I've read the terms and conditions. You can read through those if you want right here. And then click on Install Now. So now it will load WordPress for us. This page then opens up. You can see the green bar, the process at the top. Usually, I don't know, it takes 30 seconds to fully load WordPress on your new web hosting server. Almost there. And your install is complete. So you can click on View Credentials. And it takes you to this page where we can click on View. Here is your URL. Okay, that's where people will find you online, your new online store or business website. Your admin URL. Now that's what we call the back end of your website, where you will make all the changes and add any new products or add any new content from this URL here, and your username and your password will be here. You might want to write those down, or I advise that you write those down. You should be sent an email as well of that, but just handy to have that written down as well. So the first thing we will do is we will have a look. I'm just going to copy this while I'm here. We'll have a look at our website and see what it looks like. So click on the URL. And that's what it is. Now, Bluehost just has this template page up there when, as you're building your site. There is a way that we can get rid of that. If we simply go back here, and this time I will click on the admin URL. So this will take us to our WordPress dashboard. I'm sorry, it'll take us to our login panel. Okay, we've now landed on our WordPress dashboard here, our login and admin panel, I guess you can call it. And here is where you'll enter your credentials that were sent to you in the email, the credentials that you created, your username and password for your website. So I will just quickly pop mine in there. And once you have those in, you can also click on this little tab here, Remember Me. And that'll make it a little easier next time you log in. Click on log in. And here we are at your WordPress dashboard. So here, welcome to WordPress. Would you like help launching your site? We're just going to click on no thanks because you luckily have me to help you walk you through this. So once we click on that. Here is our dashboard. We'll get rid of this ad here. I don't know if yours will be showing the ad at the time of this screening anyways. I got an ad. That's the first time I've noticed that before. Okay, so don't get too frustrated as soon as you see this. I know it's the first time I saw it, I was a little intimidated. There's a lot going on there. But basically a lot of the stuff in the middle here you can just pretty much ignore. It's where all the magic happens is on the left hand side here. All these little things I'll walk you through basically what each one of these functions does throughout the tutorial. We'll be using most of them. Some of them we'll actually get rid of that we don't need. So this is basically your WordPress dashboard. Up top here, if you notice, your site title should be there. Mine's Tom's Landscaping. And let's just have a look at what the site looks like right now. So we'll just hover over your site title name and then go down to Visit Site and tap on that. And here we are. Wow, pretty impressive. Doesn't look very much like a business site at all. Very much a blog layout, and that's the default WordPress theme that we have in there for 2016 WordPress theme. And if you wanted, you could sculpt it into an amazing website, but we're actually gonna use a different theme. So first things first, we'll hover back over your site title. Get used to doing this. Go to your site title on the top left here, and then down to Dashboard, and click on Dashboard. And there we are. So the first thing we want to do is we want to clean up. When you install WordPress for the first time, there's a bunch of things on there that, you know, are bells and whistles, stuff that we don't really want to do. We want to optimize the performance of the site. We don't want anything on there that could actually slow it down or possibly get any viruses. So we will eliminate all the extra stuff. I just will call it that, extra stuff. So the first thing we want to do is go down to plugins, and then you'll see out the right here, this little window pops open, and just slide out to the right here and click on installed plugins. So WordPress comes with these default plugins installed, and we're just simply going to click on this plugin box here. So it check marks all these, and we will click on deactivate and apply. Whoops. Okay, so they're all deactivated. Again, we will click on the plugin box, checkmark them all, and then up here in this little box, we'll click that and then delete and then apply. And then it asks you, are you sure? Just confirm, click on OK. And there we go, we've deleted those. Okay, the next thing we want to do is head on down to settings. Now, I'm just going to warn you, the first part of this instructional video gets a little boring. There's a little bit of geeky, boring stuff that we have to do. We'll get into the exciting stuff later, you know, adding all the pictures and that. But we have to set up the framework just to lay the foundation of this website. So head down to settings and over to permalinks at the very bottom here when it pops out. Click on permalinks. This is a very important setting. And you'll see right up top here, it's common, or current setting is set to plain. And if you were to add any pages or whatnot, it will be, let's say, tomslandscapingsite.com/, and then this weird stuff here, this question mark P=123. That doesn't look very good to your customers, right? You want it to be slash, you know, lawn care slash snow removal. And not only does it not look good to your customers, but also to the Google search bot. I mean, when it comes and crawls your site and looks at the content, this doesn't make a whole lot of sense to it. So what we want to do is click on this down here called post name. And then whatever we type after, I'm sorry, I don't know why I did that. Whatever we type after, it will put that name in there that makes sense instead of this garbly goop. So click on post name, and then at the bottom here, click on save changes. Okay, so next thing we want to do is head up to pages and then slide over to all pages. And here you'll see we have one called sample page. We will just simply hit trash. And same thing goes for posts. So head up to posts and go over to all posts. So pages are pretty obvious what they are, you know, a contact page, about us page. What is a post in WordPress? A post is basically a blog post. So a post could be something that, you know, it's not a static page that's always on your website, like your contact page, your about page. It could be an article. Usually it would be a good way to explain it. Something, you know, 10 great tips about landscaping, or you know, five facts about, you know, the Civil War. That would be a post, right? So we're not actually putting a blog on this site anyways, but we need to get rid of this. So we will click on trash below Hello World here. There we go. Okay, the next thing we need to do is install the theme that we want to use. And the theme that we're going to use is a theme called A-Themes, it's called Sydney by A-Themes. So if I head down to appearance here and then slide over to the right, you'll see themes, click on themes. Okay, and over here it says add new theme. So we'll click on that. And you'll see a bunch of themes populate here. And it just helpful if in the future, say a year from now, you want to change the look and feel of your site and decided you wanted something different, this would be how you do it. So under popular here, we'll see what's hot right now. And you can see all these popular themes here. And like I say, I believe that the last I checked, it was something like 2,400 free themes that developers have submitted that you can use on WordPress. So the one that we're going to be using is actually in the popular section, is called Sydney. So we're simply going to click on install. If you weren't sure, if you found a different theme, up here's the search box. You would type it in here, hit enter, and then your theme will come up. So, but right now, well, actually that's what I'll do. Just in case things change when you watch this video, we'll type in Sydney. And there it is. So Sydney, we'll hover over Sydney and click on install. And then activate, click on activate. Okay, so at the top here, you'll notice this theme recommends the following plugins, and it lists three different plugins. So we want to install those, two different plugins. So click on begin installing plugins right here. And then we'll just simply click in this little square box up here beside plugin and click on install and then apply. So all installations have been complete and return to required plugin installer. We'll click on that. We need to activate them yet. So again, click on this box here, plugin, and then the drop down, and this time down to activate and apply. Okay, we've installed those required ones for the Sydney theme. Let's just have a quick look and see what the site looks like now. So hover over your site title at the top left here and then click on visit site. Okay, totally different now, right? It's looking a little more like a website. So, okay, we'll head back to the dashboard here. So hover over your site title, down to dashboard. Yeah, so that's it. Just installing a theme, you can totally change the look of your new website. So the next thing we want to do is install a plugin. So to do that, we will head down to plugins right here. It's a little, looks like a electrical plug in the wall socket plug. And then head over to the right here to add new. Click on add new. And what is a plugin? A plugin is basically a little add-on that you can add to your website that adds functionality to your website that some brilliant developer has spent hours and days and weeks developing this through all kinds of code so that us non-technical people can take advantage of it and we don't need to know a line of code, and we can just use their hard work, fortunately. And a lot of these people do these for free. There are a lot of paid ones, and sometimes they ask for donations. And last time I checked, I'm trying to remember if there's 40 some thousand different free plugins available. So that's what a plugin is. And the first one we're going to add is one called Child Themify. So up here in the search box, we'll type in Child Themify. And here it is on the left. Now each of the plugins have reviews. Very important to check out the reviews. And how many active installs. So you don't want to install, at least I avoid plugins with, you know, under 1,000 active installs. They're not proven yet. They could be exploited. And yeah, I usually just go with some proven ones. Do your research if in the future if you decide to venture out and add your own new different plugins. Google's your friend. Just do your research and see what kind of reviews they have. So this one, again, they also tell you when it was last updated. So it's 3 weeks ago. Some of them you'll see, 2 years they haven't been updated. Those ones are susceptible to being hacked. So avoid those if you can. So I don't want to scare you at first here with all this extra info if this is aimed at beginners, but I'm just trying to give you some pointers and tips on this stuff that if you retain this information about the plugins, not really required. Okay, so the next thing we will do is click on Install Now for Child Themify. Okay, it's installed, and then Activate. Now, what is Child Themify? Child Themify is a plugin that we use for our theme that we just installed, the Sydney theme. If the developer that created the coder that created the Sydney theme, if they decide they need to do some updates or make some changes in the theme, and we have a whole bunch of modifications, and then when we update our theme, we might lose some of those customizations, those modifications that we've made to the website. So in order to protect from that, we create what's called a child theme. And that's what this child Themify plugin will do for us with a couple clicks of a button. So anyways, in order to activate that, we need to go down to appearance and then over to themes. Click on themes. And this time we will go up to theme details of Sydney Interactive Theme. Just click on theme details. And in the bottom right corner here, you'll see create a child theme. So click on that. And it asks you to name the child theme. We're just going to call it Sydney Child. And then click on the Let's Go button. There you go, you've created your theme successfully. So if we go back to appearance here, or under appearance, and you'll see themes. This time, you'll see Sydney Child over here. And we want to click on the activate button. There we go. So now the Sydney Child theme is the active theme. It's the exact same as this one, only any customizations that we make will be protected. So there, we've looked after that. Remember, I said this stuff's boring, but they're necessary little tips we need to go through here. The next thing we will do is add two new plugins. So we'll go over to plugins down here and slide down to add new. And the first one that we need to search for is called Tiny MCE Advanced. Just trying to remember here. There we go. You can see this one's very popular, has over 1 million installs, and we'll click on install now. This particular plugin just allows us to do some neat things. Okay, yeah, click on activate. Do some neat things with our text, just to resize the text in our paragraphs to make it much easier to resize, make larger text. The next plugin that we need to load is called Site Origin Widgets Bundle. So again, over to plugins here and then down to add new, or you could click up here where it said add new. That's the thing with WordPress. There's multiple ways of doing the same thing. As you use it, you'll discover all the different little techniques that are basically do the same thing. This one again, Site Origin Widgets Bundle. So Site Origin, I think it was one word, actually. Okay, so I'm just gonna hit delete there. So Site Origin is all one word. There we go. Site Origin Widgets Bundle, 600,000 active installs. And we'll click on install now. Wait for the blue activate. Click on activate. There we go. Now, one other thing, once we've installed that, we need to go to activate, or sorry, the Site Origin Widgets Bundle. We need to click on Manage Widgets here. So you'll see some of them are highlighted in blue, and some of them are gray. So the blue ones are already activated. I just want you to go through and activate all of these gray ones here. Just click on activate. These are just neat little features that we'll use several of them as we're building the site. this page builder option by Site Origin has been a really big advancement in the last couple of years in WordPress. So there, we've enabled or activated all those. Now the next thing we will do is add some pages. So before I do that, let's just quick have a look. Let's go hover over your site title and click on Visit Site, and let's just see what the site looks like. Remember, we changed it to the child theme. Nothing changed. It still looks the exact same. So anyways, we will head back to the dashboard. Again, head over to your site title and down to dashboard and click on that. And this time we want to add our first page. So if we head down to pages and then click on add new. So the first one we will add is called just simply home. And important here, if you note, over on the right-hand side here, you'll see template. We want to click on that and click on front page. And then up top here, the publish button, click on that. So we're just gonna create a bunch of pages here right now. Our services. Now, if I hop back over to our finished website, you'll see we have home, our services, and contact, okay? So we'll create those. And there's another one actually called quote that we'll also create. So we've already created home. In order to make the next one up top here, you'll see add new. So click on add new. And this one is called our services. Make sure you spell it right. And again, for the template, we want front page. I know that's confusing because you're saying, hey, the home page is the front page, silly. But all of these pages that we're making, we will use just what's called the front page template. And click on publish. And then add new. And we will call this one contact. And front page template and publish. And again, add new. And our final page that we're creating for now will be the quote page. So quote. Again, front page template and publish. So now let's go have a look at the website. We've created all those pages and nothing's changed except for one thing. Now you should see this little create your menu here option, and we will click on that. Okay, when we've landed in our menu settings here, you'll notice that we have our pages here are listed that will show our menu. And we can order them in the order that we want. Just by simply hovering over, you'll see the little plus or cross sign there. And I'm going to drag contact down to the bottom here. Now, notice when I placed it there, you'll see the little box there that kind of appears. I want it in line, okay? If I were to put it over here to the right, see how it's slightly shifted to the right, it would become a submenu of the quote page, but we do not want that. We want it on its own page. So contact at the bottom, and actually quote, I don't want that in my menu. So I'm going to click on this little drop-down area or arrow here, and then over to remove. Now it's not eliminating that page, it just removes it from the menu. It didn't delete the page. So we still have the quote page. So right now you'll notice we have two homes. Okay, that's kind of confusing. We need to get rid of this one. So we will click on remove. the one that you leave is the one that says custom link, okay? So, all right. So we want to click on create menu now. And then when we do that, we will click on primary menu down here. Primary menu is just the one at the top. Put a tick mark there and then click on save menu. Okay, let's have a look, see how we made out here. So hover over your website, click on visit site, and we should have some menu options now. There we go. Home, our services, and contact. Now, I don't know about you, I'm in my mid-40s and my site is starting to go. This is very small, okay? You want to make it convenient for your customers to read, so we need to change the size of that. So the way we do that is at the top here, it says customize. So we'll click on customize. And our customize menu options come up here. Okay, so we can actually do a lot of neat, cool things through this feature as well. But the one I'll do right now is change the size of this. So the way we do that is go over to fonts, click on fonts, and then down to menu items. So there we go. Menu items. It's currently at 14. That's really small. Let's change that to 24. So I just double clicked on that. And 24, and now we'll click on saved. It says saved. I didn't see that. Okay. Oh, sorry. If I go back there, what I did was click on this arrow here, and then now we can click on save and publish. I don't know why mine didn't do that. So there we go. That's saved. Now we can click on this little X here. Much easier to read, right? Actually, while we're at it, what we need to do is, you see how here it says just another WordPress site? We need to change that. And actually, what I'm going to do is put my phone number in there, a business phone number. So let's go to, actually this title here, we'll change the size of that. So we'll go back to customize again, go into the customizer. And this time we will go into site title. And tagline, okay, so here it is, tagline, just another WordPress site. So we'll take that, highlight it, and then put in your phone number. So, and then we need to click on save. Here's if you did want to add a logo, this is where you could do it, upload your logo. But keep in mind, you want it very small. If a lot of people, first timers, make the mistake, they have a big, huge logo in it. And it really messes things up. That's why I just have text on here. But if you want to add a logo, I do it with caution. You can practice here, select your image, and then you can delete it too if you don't like it. So now the next thing we want to do is change the size. Like, this phone number is very hard to read. So we will go back to fonts and then down to site description. And this one at 16, we'll change that to 22. And back up to this arrow here, go back, and then click on save and publish. We should see the phone number increase in size. There, a little more readable now. Now we will click on the X here. Oh, actually, before I do that, we want to go to the very bottom here in the customizer, and it says static front page. So we'll click on that, and you have two options: your front page displays your latest posts or a static page. we want it to be a static page. So click on that. Then it asks you, okay, which one is your front page? And ours is our home page. So if you did have a blog, it says post page here. And this is where, if you added another page called blog, this is where you would select blog. But in this tutorial, we do not have a blog on this business website. So we'll just leave that empty. Now we can click on save and publish. Okay, once that's saved, we'll simply click back here. Actually, we'll click the X in the top right corner. And yes, we want to leave this page. I don't know why that came up on me. And back to our site here, you can see nothing has really changed. However, the next thing that I want to tackle is if we go to one of our inner pages here, for example, click on our services or contact page, you'll see at the top here, this is again called our header section up top here. And we have this image. That's just a default image that comes with the Sydney theme. We want to change that. It's not exactly going to fit in with most businesses. So what I'm going to do is go back to the customizer, click on that at the top here. And then we're looking for the header area right here. So tap on that. And then under header type at the top here, click on that. And you'll see where it says site header type, not front page header type, but site header type down here. It's currently displaying this image. We don't want it to have that. We just want to select no header. So only it says just the menu. That's all we want at the top. And then we will click save and publish. So that gives us, if we go back to our finished site here, you'll see if I go to the our services page, we have this green header. And the default one by Sydney is black. So we want to change that. So the way we do that is we'll click on the arrow here to go back. And we want to go to, click again back. And we'll go down to colors. Click on colors. And the header color we're looking for I must have missed it here. Okay, menu background. So if we click on menu background, select color, and I'm just going to click on, you can do any color you would like, whatever you feel goes with your business. The one that I'm looking for is more of a green color, almost like a grass color for this landscaping business. So I'm just going to click on this little circle here, click, hold, and drag, and try and find a shade of green that I think is suitable. And no, somewhere maybe around there. And then click on save and publish. So that was menu background. And if I pop back over here, you'll see I'm not too far off of this color. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do, click the arrow here to go back. We've changed our header color. Now it starts to get a little more exciting. We are actually going to change the slider images. So the way we do that is go up to the, or down to the header area. We'll click on that. And right here where it says header slider. So you'll see right here, first slide. So we want to change that with an image for your business. So right below it, it says change image. So we'll click on that. And now it asks you to upload some files. So when you click on the select files, it's going to go to your computer and it's going to ask you where exactly you want to. I have my images on the desktop, so I have a file here already. And the first image that I'm looking for is Trying to find it here. The snow removal one right here. So I'll double click on that. The image uploads. Now, as you take note here on the right hand side, you'll see a bunch of information. It says alt text here. This is an opportunity for you to do two things. You can use this box here to explain what the image is, and that's for people who use who are visually impaired. They use screen readers, and this would read exactly what that image was for them. Secondly, it also tells the search engines, for example, the Googlebot, exactly what that image is. And if you have some keyword in there of what the image is, so we'll just put snow plowing. That way, you're getting a few more search engine optimization points. So very important you fill out the alt text for those two reasons. And then we will click on choose image. Also, you'll notice here, my image is 1600 by 1200 pixels, okay? Pixels are a measurement in for image sizes, or in web design, we go by pixels, not inches or millimeters. Pixels, and a pixel is very, very small. So just take note of that. If you go and look here, the theme does suggest it's 1920 pixels by 1275 pixels is the default demo image size. But anyways, I've just thrown this image up here. It's a fairly large image. You want to make sure that you're choosing large images that will fill out the that area. If you were to take a small image, and you know, that was say half the size of the screen here, if we go back to our finished site here, see, this is a very large image. If we had a little image that was only half the size, it would try and stretch that image out, and the image would look distorted and blurry, and that's not what you want. You want a high definition, high quality image. And if you are not sure where to get those images, if you don't have your own high quality images off, say, your phone or your iPad or whatever, if you go to tomtattle.com and you click on the resources page here, you'll see down near the bottom, I do have some information about where you can get some high quality free images. And there's also some tools in here for manipulating those images and sizing them if you want. There's lots of good information. These are excellent resources if you're looking to do anything with your images. So again, that was tomtattle.com under the resources page. So if we head back here, that's our first image. And it says title for the first slide. And the default is Welcome to Sydney. And I'll just go back to our page here and see. Snow removal, residential or commercial. Okay, so we'll fill that in here. Again, whatever suiting to your business and your picture, that's what you'll put in there. So the subtitle was the residential or commercial. And we'll just simply click save and publish. And let's exit out of here and see what it looks like now. So I'll go back to the click on the home page. And it's the first time loading the image, so it's taking a little longer. And there we go. There's our first image on there, and you can see the description that we put in there. Pretty cool. Okay, so let's go back and continue with the second slide. It's starting to look like a bit of a business site now. So again, that was header area. And header image. I'm sorry. Header slider. And you'll notice up top here where it says slider speed, it's set to 4,000. Those are milliseconds. Slider speed is just how quickly these pictures turn. So if we crank that up to 8,000 milliseconds, obviously it's going to last twice as long. So just if you wanted to play with that, that's where you would do that. Okay, so we scroll down to second slide and change image. Again, we need to upload files. Click on select files. This time it opens up the folder that I used last time. And this image that we're looking for is right... Just trying to remember now, it's right here. So I'm going to fill in the alt text here, this time just lawn care. I won't be filling in the alt text for the rest of the images that I add, just to make the tutorial a little faster, but I highly advise you do that. It's very important that you fill that in when you upload your images. And then I'll click on choose image. And if I go back to the finished site, I just want to professional lawn care, residential or commercial. Okay. So we'll fill that in here. Professional lawn care. Oops. And then subtitle, residential or commercial. And you'll notice as I keep going down here, it says third slide, fourth slide, fifth slide. Okay. You can actually add up to five different images or services if you want in there. And you would just simply repeat for the titles and subtitles, just as we've done in the first two. But for this tutorial, we're just going to load the two. At the bottom here, you'll see call to action button. And it says URL for your call to action button. We want this to go to that quote page that we made. So we'll come back and change that later. But right now, the text for your call to action button, you see it says here to or click to begin. We want to change that to get your free quote or whatever suits your business. You can put in whatever you feel inclined to do. So get your free quote, and you can see it's going to change here to, there we go, get your free quote. Now we need to make sure that we click on save and publish. Exit out here. And our website's nicely starting to come together on the homepage here, starting to look a little bit like a business website. So the next thing we want to do is build out our services page. So if we go right now to our services page, you'll see that we have just this blank page, right? There's nothing going on here, and we need it to look like this. So we have three clickable options here, three different services. Again, depending on your business, maybe you only have one, two, maybe you have six different services. I'll show you how we can manipulate it to suit however many services you want to offer on our services page. So we'll go back here, and now that we're on our services page, you can see up top here in the menu bar, it says slash our services. We'll just simply click on edit page. Okay, so this takes us to the editor, and you'll notice in the top right here of this editing space, it says visual, text, and page builder. We want to click on the page builder option. And I'll just head back over to our finished site. You'll see we have snow removal, lawn care, and landscaping. So, and you'll see how in this one, it's nicely built into three different columns, column one, column two, and column 3. So if, for example, you only wanted two columns, then that's what you'll select in what I'm about to show you. So it says up top here, add a row. So we'll click on add row. And this one right now, when we go in, you'll see there's two columns in this row. We want to make it three. So we just simply, it says set row layout. We'll click the up arrow. And there we go. Now we have three columns. If you had only one service that you wanted to put in there, that's what you do. Just go down to one column. So we want three different services, so that's what we'll select. And we'll click on insert. Now, I had mentioned earlier, if you had six services, say for example, you wanted your page to balance out, we would, we just added a row and added three columns to it. We would go back and simply add a second row. Right here, I would do this, right? Click add row and click insert. And see there we have a second row. You could add more services here. But right now that we don't need that, we only need the three. So if I hover over this wrench here and go down to delete row and click on that, and that says, are you sure? Click again and that row's gone. Okay, so first thing that we wanna do with these three different columns is we need to add what's called a widget. So I'm just gonna click here and then I'll go up to add widget. Tap on that, and on the left menu here, it says widgets bundle. That's the one I'm gonna click on. And then it says site origin editor. So I'll click on that. And then it says, if I hover over it, it says duplicate. And I'm gonna click that twice. So now we have three of those. And simply click, hold, and drag. And again, hover over it till you get that plus sign. Click, hold, and drag over to the third column. So now each column has its own editor. And now if we hover over, you can see these options come up. Edit, duplicate, delete. We want to go in and edit. So click on the edit. And then this page will open up. And basically, if you've ever worked with word processing documents, like for example, Microsoft Word, very similar what we're building this page with, okay? You see a lot of the familiar things. We can change the font, the size of the text, center align, left align, very familiar tools you should recognize here. And just so you're not too intimidated, you've probably worked with a lot of this stuff before, so it's really easy. I'll show you. So this first column, what we have is a title of snow removal. We have an image, and then I'm just gonna highlight this. Click, hold, and drag. So if we go back, it asks for a title. So that was snow removal. And then I will click inside the main body text. You can see my cursor flashing here now. The next thing we want to do is add the picture of that tractor. So we're looking for this orange tractor. So I've got my cursor flashing there. The way I do that is click on Add Media, Upload Files, Select Files, and then find the image that you're looking for that first service. There's mine. Okay, and once that image is uploaded, I just want to point out something here. If I go back to the finished site, you see we have the three images here. So it's important that we make the images the proper width. So what I've selected for width, and we also want them the same height. So I'm doing a 300 wide by 200 in height. 300 wide by 200, 300 wide by 200. So total, I've got 900 pixels of width there with those three images. If you were only having two services, then obviously you'd want to do 900 divided by two. So you could go at 450 in width. Now, if we had different height to these images, it's just going to look really goofy. This one, let's say it was a long skinny one and it came out down here. It's, you want it to be pleasing to the eye and symmetrical lineup. So again, back at the tomtattle.com resources page at the bottom there, there's a tool called Pixlr. If you wanted to crop or resize any of your images, you would simply take your images and go into Pixlr, and you could crop them there, or you could also do it right within WordPress itself. So let's do that right now. So if I want to edit this image, the important thing is, so I clicked on edit image, scale. So we want 300. See, and then it automatically converts it, scales it on the height there to 200 for me. And then I click on scale. There we go. So that's how you do that. The main thing is all my images are the same size originally. So if you took them all off your iPad or your iPhone and you could have them all the same size, you could crop them down and your dimensions would be all proportional, as opposed to if you were getting your images off the internet and, you know, you got one from one site that was, you know, 1600 pixels wide, another one might be 900 pixels wide. It just makes things much easier if you're getting your images from the same source. So, okay. So moving on, we've scaled that image down, and then we can click back now. Again, remember to enter your alt text, and we will want to link this later on. We're going to come back to this image and link this image. I'll show you about that later, but we will, for now, we'll click on insert into page in the bottom here. Okay, so once that image is in there, we just simply hit the return button once. And then right below here is where I'm going to post or paste in that what I copied here. You can type in whatever you want. I have click for more details on our snow removal services. So if I paste that in there, the whole thing is you want to tell them to click. This is a traffic funnel. You're driving. You want to drive people to your services. Let it be easy for them. Let them know that it's a clickable image and that there's more information. So you can get them to that quote form or contact form, whatever you need as your sales funnel. And ours in this website will be our quote form. So click for more details on our snow removal services. Now I'm simply going to, where that cursor's flashing, click, hold, and drag, and just simply highlight everything. Just as I drag up to the top left corner here, you can see the image is highlighted now. And then if I go over here to Align Center, you see this? There. So now that's Align Center. Just simply click off that, and I will click on Done. And then over here on the right, we'll click on Update. And let's click on View Page at the top here and see what we got. So there we go. There's our first service. So let's add the other two. So back to edit page. And if I pop back over here, we've got lawn care and landscaping. So this one will hover over top, click on edit. This one's titled lawn care. And then we click down on the text box here and then up to add media and upload files. We'll select our second image, select files. And the one I'm looking for is right. Is not there. Oh, sorry, there it is, bottom corner. I'm losing it. Again, once this is uploaded, enter in your alt text, descriptive title of what that image actually is. And you can see this one is very large, 2617 by 1737. Click on edit image. And we want to scale this image. And I want to scale it at 300 by 199, close enough it comes up to. and click on scale. And then back at the bottom right here. And then insert into page. Again, we just click on enter once. You'll enter your descriptive text right below there of what that service is and encourage them to click on it. I'm just going to copy mine. And then highlight everything and align center. Then I just click off of the into the white space here to get rid of that and click on done. And we'll do the third one here. We'll click on edit. And this one I believe is just landscaping. And while I'm here, I will highlight my text and copy it. So the title is landscaping. And select add media, upload files, select files, and there's the third image I want in there. So to change that size, we'll simply go over to edit image on the right here. And aspect, or I'm sorry, right here, we will simply double click that and enter in 300. It automatically proportionally sizes the height to 200 for us and click on scale. Obviously, those images are massive and would not fit. So that's why we have to reduce the size of them here. Click on back and insert into page. Of course, you've already entered your alt text. Hit enter once, and then place your details just below the image. Encourage them to click on that service, and click, hold, and drag, and highlight everything, and again, align center. And then click done. And finally, update on the right-hand side there. So once that's updated, we'll go up to the top here where it says view page. And let's see what our services page looks like. Very cool. So if we go to the finish page, we got the same thing here. Only difference is, as I hover over them, you'll see that they're clickable. So I'll get back to that in a bit. Okay, so moving on, if we go back to the finished site here, and if we hover over our services, you'll see the drop-down menu appears, and we have these three additional pages. So I've got landscaping, lawn care, and snow removal. So whatever your services would be, that's what pages you will develop. Now, we're trying to develop highly targeted pages. If you were doing a, say, for example, a AdWords campaign on Google for pay-per-click, it will extremely help you if you get very targeted with your services. So that's the reason we're doing this website this way. It's just a highly converting machine when you can target your services this way and show Google that it's very relevant. When people land on their page, they're looking for landscaping. This is one of the biggest mistakes that people make in pay-per-click marketing, is they'll link the ad right to their homepage. And it, you know, the homepage has all kinds of different things going on, maybe not a whole lot of text like this one. But if you're trying to market to people landscaping and you land on a page and it's all about landscaping and nothing else, Google says this is highly relevant. We're going to make these clicks a lot cheaper. You get ranked on your page ad score. You actually get graded. So if your information is relevant, the keywords are in there, your ads are going to be a whole lot cheaper. So anyways, let's create these three pages next for this particular landscaping business. However many pages you need, you will create. So the way we do that, we'll go back over here to our site that we're building out. And then if we hover over new up top here, you'll see new, and then we can go down to page. There's many different ways of doing the same thing in WordPress, you'll find out. So click on new page. So this one is landscaping. And again, over here for template, we want to label that front page. So make sure you do that, front page template, and then click on publish. If you don't do front page template, you're going to have a whole bunch of weird things. You might have a big sidebar, you might have a big space up and a big title, and it'll just look ugly. So there's a reason why we're selecting front page template, even though they're not the front pages. Again, up top here, click on add new. And this one I'm going to call lawn care. Select the front page template and then publish. And again, add new. And we'll add our last services page, which is snow removal. And front page template and publish. Okay, so now what we want to do is, if we go back, just hover over your site title, click on visit site, and those pages that we created, you'll see they're not up top here. We have to add them to our menu. Okay, so now to add those items to the menu, we'll simply head over to our site title, click on dashboard. Actually, I missed that. I could have went a little quicker here. We will head over to appearance in the middle here, and then down to menus. Once that opens up, you'll see we have a list of the different pages that we've created. We want to click on the ones, those services that you just created. So I created snow removal, lawn care, and landscaping. They should be up top there. And then click on add to menu. So there they are. Now, if we were to save this menu, all those items would be available right across the top. And we don't want that. We want these all to be submenus of our services. So we will simply drag them, click, hold, and drag, and make sure they align to the right. So that makes them a submenu. And click, hold, and drag. And I think the first one I'll actually put up top here is going to be landscaping. So you can order them whatever way you want. And there we go. So now click on Save Menu. And let's go back to Visit Site. So now when we hover over our services, there's those pages that we created. Awesome. Okay, so let's go into the landscaping page first of all, and we will start building that out. So click on whatever your page is that you want to build out. Mine was landscaping. We want it, the end result to, if I click on landscaping here, end result needs to look like this. So we have a bunch of text, an image. Notice, I don't get too wordy, not too descriptive here. Most people, when they land on a website, you know, 2-3 sentences, large text. This is the way marketing is going. You know, pictures are worth 1,000 words. You don't want a big long page full of text here. People get bored rather quickly, and pretty soon they're hitting the back button and looking at your competitor's website. So here we have a bunch of points and a slider listing different services. Here we have the, remember I was talking about the text. We do need some text in there. And this will incorporate some keywords into our ad copy so that when Google or Bing or Yahoo's searching the website, they find these keywords and know exactly what this page is about. Also, if we're doing pay-per-click advertising, we want to make sure that those keywords are within this text too. And that the sentences that we make sense. We're not going to just stuff in keywords here and there. We need to have good flow, so we get graded on that as well. So the bottom line here, we have the another picture on the left, and then in the bottom right corner here is our free quote request. this is the capture, sales capture thing that we're after. We want them to go right through our sales funnel. So as a famous internet marketer, Gary Vaynerchuk, says, jab, 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 right hook. So, you know, we're jabbing. Here's some of our services, our images, nice, great pictures, some description of us, and then the right hook comes at the bottom here. We want them, essentially, that's what we're wanting them to do, is to click on this, click on our quote button here and get them to sign up, get in contact with us, get their contact information, and get an opportunity to sell them your services. So anyways, let's create that page out. So we are on the landscaping page. So we'll go up top here to edit page. And again, we want to go to the page builder. So click on page builder. And the first thing we're going to do is add a row. So click on add row. If we go back to the finished site here, the landscaping site, you'll notice that the first row has two columns, right? One with text, one with an image. So perfect. We don't have to change anything there. We'll click on insert and click on, just highlight this so it changes to a darker blue, and then click on add widget. And the first thing we want to do is, if you go over to widgets bundle, click on that, and then up top here you'll see site origin editor. Click on that. That's the widget we want in that one. And then highlight the second column here, click on add widget. And this one we want to add the site origin image. So that would be right here. Click on that. So we'll build out this first row simply by clicking edit as you hover over. Click on edit on this first column. And I'm going to go back and grab my text right here and just copy it. So this is where you will, you know, keep it to two or three sentences, maybe four. You don't want it stretching way down below the picture. So try and fit it nicely aligned with your image. So I will paste that in there. And for title, it was just simply, I believe I had landscaping, or maybe I could put landscaping in Pluto Moon, but I'm just making that up anyways. But you want something, something descriptive here. And preferably a keyword that you're trying to market. So landscaping for the first one. Now here's something that I do. I'll show you right now. If I were to click done here and click update and go look at this page here, you'll see how small the text is. So click on view page. I think that's too small. That's the default settings for the theme that Sydney sets. I've changed it to a larger size just so it's easier to read. So, I mean, a lot of people are using mobile devices nowadays, so we'll go back to edit page. And it can get quite hard to read the text, so we want it easy to read. We will click on edit here. And the way we will adjust this text size is just simply click, hold, and drag, highlight it all, go to font sizes, and we're looking for 18. So just click on 18. And I just click off to the side there, click on done. And that's changed that. While we're here, we'll also add this image. So click on edit. And this is our site origin image widget. And right here, we will click on choose media. And then upload files, select files. And this is where you will upload your image. I have a bunch of sod here, so I guess that's this image here. So it uploads, and then we will, and you can see it's a fairly large image, 1600 by 1065. I'm not going to touch that size. I'm just going to click on set media, and the widget will automatically resize that to fit the area, and then click on done.
And let's click on update. And view page. And see what we got here. So there we go. There's our first row. Perfect. So we go back over here. You'll see our second row is now an image slider. Actually, it's not just a single image. There's several images in there. And then some a title followed by some bullet points of our services. So just going to highlight those. You can list your various landscaping services or whatever it is, more detailed services here. Go back here, click on edit page. And this time we want to add another row. So click on add row. It's already got the two different columns for us. That's perfect. And then highlight this one, click on add widget, widgets bundle. And this time we want to select the site origin slider. So right here, not the layout slider, but the slider, site origin slider. And while we're here, we will highlight this particular column, click on add widget, and this one will be the site origin editor. So while I'm in the editor side here, I will click on edit. And I believe it was titled landscaping services. So you can put a title there for whatever suitable to your business. And remember, I need to resize this text. So I'm just going to simply click, hold, and drag and change the font size to 18. And then come down here, click on done. And now I will hover over here, click on edit. Now, one thing I want to point out, as I hover over here, you can see there's edit, duplicate, delete. If I hover over the wrench, we have edit row, duplicate row, delete row. Don't get those confused. Okay, I know it's kind of easy to hover over and get the wrong thing. So just be aware of that. If we did want to make any edits to this whole row, like both these columns, we could do that over here. But I'll show you that later. So the site origin slider, we want to click on edit. And here is where we will add a bunch of images. So the way we do that in the slider is simply come up top here and click on add under slider frame. And then this drops down. You'll see this little arrow here. So we click on that and this drops down. We are searching for, select under background image, select choose media. Click on that. Again, back to the upload files, select files. And here is where you want to select your image, your first image. So putting in the pile of mulch. Then click on set media. Be sure to fill in your alt text. And as I come down here, click on add again. It's kind of hard to find, but once you've done it a few times, you'll get used to it. And then this little arrow. And choose media. Upload files, select files, and put in your second picture. Click on set media. Go down to the grayish add section again, click on that, click the little down arrow under background image again, select choose media, upload files, select files. I hope you're getting the hang of this. I hate sounding so repetitive, but that's often what web design is. So once that's uploaded, click on set media. Once you've make sure you've filled in your your alt text there. Hover down, go to add again. And again, you can do this as many times or as few times as you need to for the amount of images that you need. I'm just trying to remember all my different images. That I had in the slider. I think I had 5 or 6 of them. Click on set media. Oops. And I believe I have one more to add. Click on the gray add, click on the down arrow. And background image, we want to choose media. Upload files, select files. I'll just click on that one. That one looks good. Okay, once that's uploaded, click on set media. And now we can click done. Over to the right here, click on update. And then up top here, we can click on view page. Let's see what we got. There we go. Just takes a while initially for the images to load. You'll notice that, actually, one thing I didn't change, I could change the speed of this slider. It's going pretty slow. I believe it's set to 8 seconds. If you wanted to change that, I can show you. Oh, one other thing I want to do is, if you look at here, it's all white background. It kind of blends in. We want to create a little separation. If we go to the finish page, you'll notice we got like a gray background here. So I'll show you how you do that. So go back to edit page. And this time, remember I was talking about the row. If you hover over this wrench and then click on edit row and then over to theme, and we simply want to do two changes here. We want row layout where it says standard here. We want to change that to full width. And the second thing we want to do is change the background color. So right here. So click on select color and just point your mouse kind of where you want it. I like this grayish color here. So DB, 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 that's the hex code number. DB, DB, DB. If you want to copy that and make sure all your gray backgrounds are the same, you could do that. You can write that down for later. So we'll click on done. And I also mentioned that the slider, I'll show you how to change the speed of that. So if we click on edit here, so if we wanted to change that frame speed, this timeout here button, see it says 8,000. Let's switch that out to 4,000. Whoops. So things should go a little quicker here. Click on done and then update. You might want to experiment and with that number there. We'll click on view page. And then we see our slider now should be going a lot quicker. Well, not a whole lot quicker, but a little quicker anyways. So you can experiment with that number and place it exactly where you feel comfortable with for displaying your services. So the next thing we want to go to is add the third row. This third row, again, was simply a bunch of text explaining our business and with some strategically placed keywords that will impact our search engine ranking and also our costs when we do pay-per-click advertising. So, whoops, while I was there, I'm just going to simply copy mine. And if you read this text here, you'll see it gives kind of some instructions as to exactly what you should have in here and how long, how many words, how many times you might want to place the keywords. So anyways, I will go back to the page we're working on, click on edit page. This time there's only one column, if you noticed, that was all a big block of text there. So we will click on, we'll click on add row. And instead of two columns, this time there's only one. Click on insert. And you'll see it popped it in here right above our second column. So we want to move that down. Now, the way you move that down, to the right of the wrench here, just hover over that. When you get that little cross, click, hold, and drag, and there we go. So we've moved that into the third position. This time, we'll click on that to highlight it. Click on Add Widget and Widgets Bundle. And over here to Site Origin Editor. Hover over until we, over here, click on the edit. And I'm just simply pasting in my text here. And for title, I have no memory. Landscaping Services in Pluto Moon. Okay. So you will put in your appropriate title. And remember, we need to resize this text. So click, hold, and drag. And the size was 18. Okay. Click on Done. And while we're here, we will add another row. So click on Add Row. And this time, we want two columns. And click on Insert. So the final row was an image, and then this basically it's a call to action button. They call it a little button here where we will get them to go to our quote page. So we want to drag that down to the bottom. So hover over this little arrow at the far right, and click, hold, and drag to the bottom, and click here. In the left column, we will click on Add Widget, and this one is Site Origin Image, so right here. Now we'll click over here, highlight this column, click on Add Widget. Now this one is not part of the Site Origin Widgets bundle, so don't make the mistake of adding their button or call to action here. The one that we're looking for this one is called Sydney call to action. So Sydney FP call to action. So click on the Sydney themes widget, and then right up at the top corner here, this one, Sydney FP call to action. And that one, you'll notice that the button color, everything matches the theme. So the first thing we'll do, the easy one, we'll add this image. So click on Edit, and then choose Media, and Upload Files, and Select Files, and there's my image that I'm putting in. And then click on Set Media, and Done. And then we'll go over to the Sydney call to action one, hover over that, click on edit. This one asks you for a title, and my title is just simply free quote request. And then I'm just going to highlight this while I'm here. And then enter your call to action. Mine just says, let us do the heavy lifting, contact us for a hassle-free quote on your next project. And then the title for the button is going to be free quote or free quote request. And we still have to come back once we create our quote page. So right now we're just going to click done and then update. And view page. There, so if we go down here, got our slider going. Oh, right, one thing that I missed. The background. We want this to not blend in, so we need to add the gray background. So, again, go back to edit page. And then, remember how we fix a row? We hover over the wrench, click on edit row, over to theme, background color, and it was right around here. That's where, if you wrote that number down, you could just simply put it right in there. I'm just being sloppy here and not being exact, but I'm pretty close. Anyways, it's not going to be a huge difference. It was right in this area. And the other thing that we need to do is select the row layout for this one, and we'll go to full width and then click on done and update. And back to view page. And there we go. Looks pretty good. Okay, to speed up things here, if we just look at our finished website here, you'll see we still have a lawn care and a snow removal page to develop. If I click on them, they're slightly different than the page that we just developed. You notice instead of having four rows, they're only three. So we have what exactly it's missing is they don't have the slider and the block of text and list of services. Now, if you wanted, you could add that in, but just to show you, they don't have to be all the same. I've made it slightly different. We just have our text up here, image, our keyword information, again, another image, and then our call to action, our capture their email and information to possibly get a lead in a sale. So I will quickly make one of these pages and then you can do the other one. I'll just show you how I do it quickly. So if I go to our finished site here and, for example, go to lawn care, and then click on edit page at the top, and over here we want to go into the page builder. And we will add a row. And the first one is going to be two columns. So I'll click insert. I will add another row. The second one is going to be one column. I'll click on insert. And then I will add a third row. And this one will be two columns. And click on insert. And I'll drag that to the bottom. Sorry, I'm going really fast here. Okay, so now I need to add my widgets. So this one I will click on and then add a widgets bundle site origin editor. And then over here was a, add widgets. And this is a site origin image right there. This one is a site origin editor, and this one, add widget, site origin image, and then finally the bottom right corner, ad widget, and this one was the Sydney call to action. Okay, so we've got all our rows, columns, widgets in place, and that's the basic layout. I will let you go through and add your own text, for example, just like we did in the previous one, images, and again, the call to action will be the exact same for whatever service you have. Okay, just skipping ahead now, I've added the two other pages under our services, the snow removal page and the lawn care page. So that's what mine looks like, just like the original. Anyways, if you had any issues, whatever, just go back over, rewind the tutorial back to when we were building the landscaping page. It's the exact same process. Only difference is we just don't have this second row. So, but your second row will be a gray background full width. Don't forget that. And okay, so moving on, we need to do a contact page. So click on contact, click on edit page. This one's going to be pretty simple. Go over to page builder. And if we go to our finished site here, you'll see the contact page is a full width contact page right there. So the way we easily get that is if we click on layouts, and it says, do you want to browse the pre-built layout directory? And we will click enable. And the one that we're looking for is this simple business contact. So we'll click on that. And then, so it's highlighted. And then at the bottom right here, it says insert. Click on insert. And then it says insert after, before. We'll just say insert after. Doesn't matter. And here it's already been pre-built for us. So now we can simply click on update. And then let's go view page. So this is the default way it's laid out, okay? It's not exactly the same as our finished one. So if we go over to our finished one, you'll see that I've added, it is the same except for this prefer personal touch and then some social icons and whatnot down at the bottom here. And we need to edit that phone number. So I'll show you an easy way to do that. And up at top here, contact us. We would love to help. Feel free to say hello. That's up to you if you want to edit that. So the way we can do that, if you click on this live editor button. So you'll see over on the left here is each of our widget sections. And as we hover over something, you can see the different sections changing, okay, on the left-hand side there, and that's where we can make our edits. So let's first of all change our phone number. So just simply click on this. It'll open up that section. Prefer a personal touch. If you want to take that out, you're more than welcome. And here we can enter in our phone number. Edit it anyways. 123. I'm just making a fictitious phone number here. And at the bottom here where it says, give us a shout and let's have a chat. You can change that to whatever you want. I'm just gonna leave it as is. You might wanna capitalize that if you do choose that. And that's basically all that I'm gonna do here. So click on done. So there's our updated website or phone number. Now that doesn't look too good. That will change once we are finished here and we're on our, see, we've got this menu here and it's pushed the phone number over to the side. That will change, trust me. Social icons, we can click on that. So here, if you do have a Facebook account, you can put your Facebook page URL right here. Just copy that, whatever that is on your Facebook page, and plunk that in there. Again, same with Twitter, Instagram, whatnot. Let's say your email as well. They can contact you at the bottom here. Click on this, and for email, you can simply put mail to and then colon and then your email address. So tom@tomtattle.com. So that's it for your email. The other thing, Instagram here, URL. Let's say we don't want Instagram. We don't have Instagram. We want to take that out. Just simply click on the X. Are you sure it asks? Confirm. Instagram's gone. You can do that with all those if you don't want any social media icons on the bottom there. And I'll click on done. So you notice when we're on the finished site, if I were to click on the mail now, it would go open up my email platform and automatically be able to email you. The other thing we want to change here, that's good. I'm good with that. And if you did want to change this text up here, again, just simply click on the area. And right down here, you can change the text. So that's it, done. And I'm going to hit done up top here. And now make sure you hit update to save all the changes that we made. And let's have a look at our contact form now. There we go. So you can test that out. Your name, email, subject, message, contact us. Right, we hover over this. Your email platform will open up. Now, one thing that I failed to mention, a very important point, if we go back into the edit page section of our contact form, so you're on your contact page, go to edit page, and under the site origin contact form, simply click on edit, and there is a important point here. Under settings, you want to tell exactly where you want this contact form to go, and that's how you do it. So simply click on settings, it drops down, and the to email address, you will simply erase that default address that's in there and place your email address in there where you want the form to go. So once you've done that, you entered your address, you will click on done, then you will click on update. And then we'll just simply go to view page. And if you were to test that out now, everything's going to work just fine. Next thing I want to do is go to our quote page. So simply click on one of your services, head down to the bottom here, and click on your free quote request. That'll take us to our quote page. The whole purpose of this sales marketing funnel is to get them to our free quote page. We need to get their contact information, phone number, email, and be able to, you know, pitch your services to them. So very important page here. I'll show you how we build it. It's very similar to the contact page that we just built. So if I slide over to our site here, and if we simply click on pages and all pages, and you'll see the quote page that we had created earlier on, and then just simply below quote, click on edit. So with this one, we want to go to the page builder. So click on page builder, and we will click on pre-built layout. And the exact same one that we used before, the simple business contact form, we will click on, and then down at the bottom we'll click on insert, and then insert after, and there we go. So again, just like the contact form, exact same thing placed in here, only this time we have to make some edits. So if we go into the top row here and click on edit, you'll see the text at the top here says contact us. Now we want that to say free quote, and then our subtitle will be Please fill in our quote form and we will reply within 24 hours. So I'm just going to copy that. And then free quote for up top here for the head title. And then the subheadline, we will change that. Put in whatever you feel comfortable with there. And I believe that's it for that top section. Click on done. And then the contact form area, we will click on edit. In this area, probably the trickiest of them all. If I just go back to the please fill in our quote form. Okay, so we need name, email, phone, and address. I'm going to change. So the way we do that, right now we have name, email, it's got subject. We need to change that subject. And I want to capture a phone number. If you don't want to add the phone number as a required element that you want from your customer, you don't have to do that. You can just simply click this X here and eliminate that subject line. But we're going to add phone here. So what we will do under where it says subject, we will just go down to the text and click on text. Now, when we select text, all that means is you'll see each one of these field inputs is one line, one line. One line, that gray area, that's a text area. Or sorry, that's the text box. This larger one where it looks like it's about three different lines, that would be a text area. So when we need to select the various field types, that's what we want right now. It's just the one line, it's a text. And for label, it was subject, and we want to put in phone or phone number, whatever you would like. And you can select if that's a required field or not. Just simply what that means is when the person's filling out the contact form and then they click, you know, contact us at the bottom, and then it will say, hey, you didn't fill in this area. We need you to fill this in before we can submit it. So that's simply what a required field means. Pretty self-explanatory. The next thing we want is a where it says message. We want to change that to, instead of text area right now, we want another, just text instead of text area. And we will change this to address. See how I did that? Just like the contact form before, each one of these, you hit that little arrow, it drops down. And address, is that a required field? I'm not going to force them to give me their address. It would be nice if we're doing a quote, for example, for a landscaping job to know their address, but actually, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to make that required. Again, all dependent upon your business if what these fields are, if you feel they should be required or not. And then below that, we will click on this gray area where it says add, and then the little down arrow. And this time, the field type will be a text area. And label, if I go back over here, you know what? I did that wrong. So right below address, instead of, this is the text area down here, we have these little options here where you can tick off, you know, what options you want information on. So I will, that's easy. Instead of text area, we will call these checkboxes. That's the one you want to select. And the label is just simply, please select your service. And we have snow removal, landscaping, and lawn care. So for label, that's your title. Please select your service. And it's not going to be a required field. We won't penalize them for not filling this in. And we have to, you'll see this blue area where it says options, we have to add an option. So we click on add, click the down area, and under value is our first one. So snow removal. And then click the blue ad area again below that, the little down arrow for value lawn care is our second option. And again, below that, the little blue ad area, the down arrow, and our last one would be landscaping. Okay, and this time we want to add that text area right at the bottom here after those little checkbox questions. And I'm just going to highlight what I have to say here. So this larger box, the text area. So instead of the blue one, we want to go to the gray add now. Click on add, the down arrow. And this time we want a text area. And then for label, that's where I'm just going to paste this in. Please include any other details to help us with our quote. For example, commercial or residential property, you know, blah, blah, blah. Whatever is related to your business. If you want to get some more details in this section here, you can. Is that a required field? No, I'm not going to make that a required field. And that's basically it. I'm going to click done. I will click update. And once that's updated, we'll have a look at the page by clicking view page at the top. And let's check it out, make sure everything's correct. Free quote, please fill in our quote form. Name, email, phone, address. Options here. You can select multiple if you wanted. They can fill in any other details and then send it. Okay. So if I were to hit that, right, these were required fields, so it's asking me to make sure I fill in something. So remember, if you want to make those required fields or not, just that's that little tick. Okay, so we just need to clean up a little more stuff. This bar at the bottom here with the social icons and phone number, you can go in and change that, put your phone number in there, your social icons. Me personally, I'm just going to strip that right out. So we'll go back to live editor, edit page. We could have done it in the live editor too, I guess. And that is this section here. We are simply just going to hover over the wrench and then down to delete row. It says, are you sure? Click again. Yes. And then click update. And now when we go back to the page, there. So it's just a simple contact for or a quote form, no other information to distract them. So now that we have the clean contact form, we must make sure we enter our email where we want this contact form to go, just like the this quote page where we want it to go, just like the contact form. If we simply go up to edit page and exact same thing as you did with the contact form, we'll go into the second row here, the site origin contact form, click on edit, and that settings, click on that, it drops down. And again, you'll enter your email address right up here. And once you've entered that, you can simply click on done and update. And then I encourage you to test out your form after that and make sure that it works. So go back to view page and test it out. So we've got our quote form. One thing that we need to do now is link this quote form. So if I'm going to, actually I just need to hit the back button here. Okay, so now up top here we got, you know, whatever your website address is, .com or whatever, /quote. So I'm just simply going to copy that and now I need to make some links. If you recall, if we go to the homepage on the finished site right here, get your free quote, right? So we click on that, that takes us to the quote form. So how we fix that is simply go up to customize. And then we go to the header area. And then the header slider. Click on that. We go all the way to the bottom here. And the URL for your call to action button. That's that get the free quote button, that red one. Remember where we copied that the web address for our contact form? So we'll just simply hit paste in there, Command V if you're on a Mac. That changes that, and then we can hit save and publish. So again, it'll be whatever your website address is / quote, and then you can put the trailing slash in there. So that's saved. So now we can close this and go back to our homepage and click on the call to action button this time. There we go, right to the quote form. So there's some other areas, three other areas. If we go to the landscaping page, first of all, under our services, and if you recall, down at the bottom here was free quote request. We need to add a link there and actually on our other two services. So if I simply go to edit page and then at this Sydney FP call to action down at the bottom here, we click on edit. And hopefully you still have your address copied. I'm gonna just hit Command V or paste in here and then click done. So that's again, whatever your website address is / quote, or whatever you called your quote page. Hopefully you followed the tutorial and called it quote. And then hit update. And let's view the page. Double check our work here, make sure that that works. And there we go, there's a quote form. So again, you need to repeat that for snow removal and lawn care. I'll just quickly run you through. I clicked on the second one, snow removal. Click on edit page. The third one, I'm not gonna walk you through. You can do that yourself. the call to action, Sydney call to action one, you click on edit. And then link for the button. Paste it in there. Hit done. Hit update. You get the picture, so you'll do that for each one of your call to action buttons. Okay, we're almost complete here. One last thing that we need to do, we can simply go back to view page. And if we hop over to our home page, you'll see as we try and scroll down here, that's all we have is just the image slider. If we go over to the finished page, you'll see if we scroll down here, we have a text area. And it's important that I'm just gonna copy this title while I'm here. Important that we have this text area on our homepage just for the search engines to identify exactly some information about our homepage. So just a small little blurb at the bottom there, and also for our customers if they are happening to land on that page and want some more information there. So what I will do is go back to the page we're working on and go into the dashboard. So hover over your site title, down to dashboard, over to pages, slide out to all pages, click on that. And then you'll see where it says home, front page, and we will click on edit. Over to the page builder, click on that. And right here, we will add a row. And that was just simply one row, one column. Click on insert and highlight it and click on add widget. And this time we'll click on widgets bundle and site origin editor. Hover over your row, click on edit. It asks for a title. So I'll put my title in there. You can put whatever title you find appropriate for your business. And if I hop back over here, I'm just going to copy. You know, you're looking at, you know, anywhere from 3 to 5 sentences on that home page is what I would recommend. So I'll copy that and just simply paste mine in here. And again, I will highlight all of, whoops. See, I made a mistake there. I'm just going to show you something. See this undo button, the arrow going to the left? Hit that and it fixes what I just messed up. So highlight all of that. And I want to change the font size to 18. Click off of that, and I think that's looking good there. Okay. I can click on done and update. Now we'll view the page. And as we scroll down, there we go. There's our text.
Okay, that concludes our More Leads website tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And as always, if you have any questions, you can get a hold of me below in the contact section below, or you can get a hold of me at the contact form on tomtattle.com. Now, I also mentioned I would show you how to drive traffic to your website. Now, what you need to do is go to tomtattle.com/traffic. That's tomtattle.com/traffic. And that web page, there's a four-part series with video tutorials to walk you through all the important things that a first-timer needs to do to the website to ensure you generate lots of traffic. And I guarantee you, it will generate leads. It works for me. It does for all my clients. And it's the exact process that I use for driving sales for a service-based business. So again, thank you very much. As always, please, if you got any use out of this video tutorial, I really appreciate it, and I thank you if you give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to my channel for more upcoming tutorials and sales tactic ideas and how you can drive more sales to your business. So simply click on the TomTattle.com logo, the TomTattle.com logo in the bottom right corner, and you can subscribe to the channel. So I appreciate your time. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.